Now let's work on creating the event frame analysis that we'll use to store an event anytime the expected regeneration forecast is greater than or equal to 11 hours. We will base our notification rule on this event frame analysis. An event frame template has been created for you to use already. After walking through its configuration, we will configure an analytic to generate the event frames themselves. In PySystem Explorer, select the library view. Under the Templates branch of the hierarchy, expand Event Frame Templates and select the Regeneration Time Notification template. The naming pattern is specified under the General tab. Select the Attribute Templates tab at the top to see the list of attributes. Expand the Attribute Configuration dialog by clicking on the left arrow along the right-hand border of PySystem Explorer. You can see that this particular template will store the forecasted regeneration cycle time and the last drying cycle time. Just like in the previous event frame, these are merely placeholders to contain the result of an asset analytic calculation which occurs upon the end or close of the event frame. We will configure this calculation in the next steps. In PySystem Explorer, navigate back to the dryer element template in the library under Element Templates. Click and navigate to the Analysis Templates tab. Create a new analysis template and rename it My Dryer Notification. Set the analysis type to Event Frame Generation. Uncheck Enable Analysis when creating from template. Assign the event frame template to Regeneration Time Notification. And note that the example element has been assigned to Dryer A by default. Similar to our My Dryer Regeneration cycle time forecast, we will be using AF Analytics array functions to grab the timestamp of the latest drying event. We will be creating a multi-line analysis utilizing the multivariable capability of AF Analytics. The first step in our analysis is to find the last drying event. We will be making use of new AF Analytics functions that allow for array calculations. Let's use the recorded values by count function to grab the past 10 states of the dryer. Create a variable called past 10 states and input the formula you see on your screen. This operation will create an array of 10 values consisting of the past 10 states the dryer has had. To view the output of the operation, click on Evaluate and hover your mouse over the blue information symbol next to the evaluation. We now want to filter this array to only capture the states where the dryer is in drying mode. Create another variable called past drying states and input the formula you see on your screen. This operation will create an array of filtered values consisting of the past drying phases and their associated timestamps. Finally, let's grab the most recent drying event. Create a new variable called last drying event and input the formula you see on your screen. This operation grabs the timestamp of the first value in the past drying states array or the most recent drying phase's associated timestamp. Next, for your event frame analysis, add a start trigger with the logic that you see on your screen. Then add an end trigger with the logic that you see on your screen. This event frame will be captured and begin and end when the predicted regeneration cycle duration is greater than or equal to 11. To write the forecasted regeneration cycle time and the last drying cycle time attributes of the event frame template, we will be using output expressions. Add an output expression called current forecast and input the expression you see on your screen. This expression will output the value of the predicted regeneration time at the start of the event frame. Map this output expression to the forecasted regeneration cycle time attribute of the event frame template. Then add another output expression called last drying cycle and input the expression that you see on your screen. This expression will write the value of the last drying event variable you created previously. Map this expression to the last drying cycle time attribute of the event frame template. Your complete MyDryer notification event frame should look like the one that you see on your screen here. Click on the Evaluate button to preview the results and make sure that there are no errors. If it all looks good, check in your changes. Return to the Management view in PySystem Explorer. Select the My Dryer Notification Analyses for Dryer A and B elements. On the right-hand side, under Operations, click Enable. Once the green checkmark appears in the status column, the analyses are up and running. Again, under Operations, click on Queue. This exposes the backfilling configuration dialog. Configure the start and end times to be *-7D and *, respectively. And finally, click on Queue to start backfilling event frames for the two dryers.